Dr. Anish, as you are from Kerala, how is Christianity in Kerala? People from other states, particularly from Andhra, people think that Christian conversion is rampant throughout India. But how is it in Kerala?
You'll be really surprised to know that almost more than 90-92% people of Christians are not believers in Kerala. You know, it's a really surprising. And I was studying in Karnataka too. So there also, I think, and Goa also, I think 90% of Christians are not believing Christians. They are not Christians because they are born in a Christian family. They are just following that faith, and they are not into a born again type of Christianity. So in fact, in Karnataka as well as in Kerala, I have seen people, some missionaries, they go to Hindu's house. So Hindus says, why can't you go to the next house? There is a Catholic there. Why don't you tell them those things? So let them go first there, then you come here. Now I've seen it in Kerala also, same issue in the videos and all I have seen. And it's a very paradox that, you know, that St. Thomas, some believe that he had come to Kerala and converted many and all. But people now do not follow that path. They are not into a conversion path at all.
So basically what you are saying is there are no conversions in Kerala. Do you mean to say that there are no evangelical conventions going on in Kerala?
Yeah, a few years back I used to hear of this evangelical conventions, posters and all, and a lot of healing and all. But recent few years it has totally been stopped. I hardly see, maybe somewhere here and here you hear, very rare. So I personally, in my place, I have seen one or two meetings. But the attendance was almost nil. Because of nil attendance, you only see first two rows, some poor people from that church, they will be sitting there. And at last they have to close down the business and they do not conduct because of almost a nil attendance. Nobody comes to these meetings. In fact, my area, so many areas people start and they close the program. And because of failure, they do not continue with the prayer groups or prayer meetings are not at all encouraged by Christians themselves. But you hear some places that people have converted and they found something, but very rare. Openly, people don't do it. Even though there are so many vulnerabilities, you see that people die in accidents, people become widow, there is a Nipah cases, there are calamities, flood. But even despite all these things, you hardly see this conversion group coming and converting people there. In fact, you will be surprised to know that Catholics don't even allow this Pentecostal type of people in their houses. So one of my friend recently said, I said, why you don't allow them? No, they are like camel, doctor. Once you allow the head, then the whole body comes inside the house. Then they won't go. And I remember one of the Catholic lady only told me, you lose your self-confidence once you get into it. So this and over that, Pentecostal is made fun, called Pedanticost, you know, the torturous. I said torture, Pedit, you know, so Pedodontist. That Christians themselves know, those who are converting also knows that it is a tough thing to do. And it surprises me that West people are becoming atheist. So see, they are not believing in God, but they go into religion, then they come out. In Kerala, they are neither atheists, but they are neither believers. And they know some of the things more than these Christians. They don't become believer to come out. So people now, believers may say, it is difficult to lead a life. They want to sin, drink, enjoy. So I want to ask, we had A.K. Antony, defense minister. We had Uman Chandy. Or we have so many ladies at 70, 60, 50 years of old who are good doctors, philanthropists. What sin they are doing? See, it is easy for them to change the church. They are already born in a Christian family. They can just change the church to a Pentecostal or Baptist, Protestant. They can lead the... Listen, are they stupid? So believers may say that they don't have a will. I have a will. No, no, no. They are not stupid. There must be some reason, right?
So according to you, what are the reasons for them not getting into Adventist churches?
See, what Christians feel, it is very tough. Hindus have brought it to their house. That is the one thing that I want you all to stress, that they don't know their God. See, first of all, it is a practical way. You know, they also think like Hindus. They also want to live happily like Hindus or Muslims. They want to do the business, do things on their own way. You know, they don't want to surrender to everything as a prayer, like waiting for something that they don't know about it. So they also think and do same way like we do and think. And actually, as the series goes on, you will understand that there are a lot of practical problem associated with it. So first is this practical impossibilities. See, you have this, I see believers telling, I prayed, I got first in the education and go. But you see in that school, there are dance competition and there are filmy dance. Now, how can a believers or preachers, pastors, they don't encourage their children to participate in this type of dances or filmy dance? They can't, it's all fear. You know, they have the image of this fear thing. Then second, if you see, this most of the Christians work in Gulf. They are working in the Muslim companies or the Muslim owners in Kerala too. They are working in Hindu companies or shops of a Muslim or Hindus. And you go there, you tell them that this is not the good way. You should also tend to my way. It's not possible. They earn salary from there. Teachers, doctors, medical help, medical students, all are taking education from all these Hindus, non-Christian people. And suddenly after coming out, you say they are the children of devil. They are sinners. And you yourself are not a good doctor. You yourself are not a good IAS. But you want them to come to here and be useless. See, these are the people. See, I want to say that, especially when you are a believer, because of religion, you could not be a good doctor or IAS or something like that. Now, when you see IAS, you tell them you come into his, and as soon as he converts into Christianity, then you propagate that, you promote that IAS has accepted Jesus. So all these things, like you take help daily basis, medical treatment, education, everything from non-believers to see them as a sinners. It is their way that has made them a good doctor, and you are asking them to come to your way. See, it is not at all a practical thing in Christianity. So they know that it is, and you go get beaten up. So, then that family, you know, in a family, different people have different ideas. You leave for your family. You cannot make your family hunger because of your religion. So that is a practical thing in this generation. It doesn't work much that way. Then another is transparency. See, I remember once Kannur, a pastor told me, my mission is only for Hindus. You know, it's Kerala has a lot of Muslim, Hindu, Christians population. They live in a very secular fabric and they are close to each other, helping each other. And now you are supposed to preach, then you preach to everyone. So this Kannur pastor told me that this is only for Hindus. I don't want to disturb my ministry. And now how much chapter of Bible you read, this Psalms chapter, you don't have guts or you don't have strength in Jesus to go to preach a Muslim family. In fact, I remember a case where a Catholic professor had written something against, it was actually meant to be something else. He had written the name Muhammad. The Muslim got very angry and the police arrested him, the Muslim extremist chopped off his hand one day. Now he is struggling here and there, and everyone was remained mute spectator. Nobody could help them. Even Christians could not help the teacher. So they know that they go to preaching, get some beaten up or hand chopped off. Nobody will come at the end. So that fear is there. So it is not something very practical in Kerala. In fact, in George Kurian, he is a BJP minority cell leader. So in TV once he was telling that most of these minority attacks or problems are because of this Pentecostal. See, this 99% cases what they are telling, they will go to some place, take a room, start praying. And so other flat people has to study or not. Their children are studying. So he himself is categorically said that this Pentecostal is an issue for things like this. Now you start seeing in a college. When I was studying in college, I especially want to say there were 140 Christians, denominational Christians. After that, only 10-12 were this. And I will tell in the later series what is the condition of five people. So they mix around with other religion people, other state people. They go for parties, functions. They talk normal, practical things. Then once you become Christian, you can't mix around with them. Then where you are going to study, where you are going to patch up with them in your life. So these are the practical impossibilities we have.
So another interesting question which I had for Dr. Anish was, we saw a trans movie recently, it was dubbed in Telugu. It is a huge hit in Andhra and Telangana. Of course, we had a Facebook discussion, we have YouTube discussions on that. But what was the impact of trans in Kerala? And another question is, what impact does it have on Christianity?
See, this trans movie was not a very big hit in Kerala because, as I told you already, the reason people could not relate much that to the movie because we already knew in Kerala that this type of things go on because we see videos where a pastor is praying that your three sons has got married or not married, then that person corrects himself, no, they are not married or married, you know, contradicts. So it's all viral and you see same patient coming to different meeting and different thing. And there are other videos also. So there are other movies which also says a lot about this Bible God. See, this trans movie, most of the people stressed on that fake pastor. See, this fake pastor is biblical. You know, Christians may say that. Bible also says it's a fake pastor. So it's basically a story on fake pastors. Hindus or non-Christians may say that this is how it happens. I don't want to stress on that. I want to stress on that particularly that kid case. You know, that sick kid was there and that father is praying, putting oil, and later the kid dies. And the worst mental illness of that situation is that father takes the kid to the pastor again so that the child can come alive. See, this is a mental illness that has. I myself remember when I went to pastor, they said, anything goes wrong, you blame God. Then I said, like anything good, then these people will say, it's all because of Jesus. So it's not only because of the problem related to death also, it's also in families or the financial business you do. Once you have the first loss, then you wait that to be corrected by God. Then you ended up in second loss. Then the issue goes on till you someone helps and comes and intervenes and helps you out, or you really become depressed. In UP it has happened, one child died. They were recent converts, and 2 days, 3 days that parents are sitting with the dead child waiting for the miracle, and later the police had to intervene and has to be taken in that way. So that's a trans movie.
Are there any other Kerala movies? Because I heard that there were a lot of movies like trans before also. So can you enlighten us with some other interesting movies?
Yeah, see, this Kerala movies actually never did a movie totally on this subject, but they always said something about the way of God does in their stories when the Christians' family are protagonist in that movie. So one of the movies, like I remember, because generally Kerala movies shows Pentecostal or this Protestants as a people who are not in reality. They are somewhere praying, hallelujah, hallelujah, and they are not in reality. They pray for everything, not only related to the things, they don't see movie. So they don't consider as a normal people by their movie industry only. So usually what they show is basically a denominational Christian and the churches and the Bible related to that. So they know the God and they make stories out of it. One of the movies I want to say is Memories. It's a Prithviraj movie. So if you see that movie, he's a honest police officer. His wife and child gets killed in an attack. So later he becomes a drunkard. And so then he investigates the case. So once a church father comes and tells, come to church and all. Then he says, God has, if God has to take away, why did he give me a wife and child? Your God is a cruel God. He's a cruel. Then father says, don't say like that. He has his ways. Then he says, this is a victory of your type of people. It's a victory. You have answer for everything. If you see righteous people who are sick, then you will say that poor, then you will say that ways of righteousness is narrow and full of thorns. If I show you evil people who is rich, successful, then you will say they are lifted by God like palm. So go farther. Then later if you see that movie, he doesn't go for a prayer meeting. He goes for a de-addiction center in the church and he has come out. There's another movie where it is made as a joke way, you know, like a contractor comes and gives a bribe. Then the PWD officer, God, are you testing me? Like he looks at Jesus. Same way like a prostitute or womanizer, they see a customer or a girl or a boy. After he has repented, then he says to God, are you testing me? So it's a joke, like thief, if he has left all these things, then he sees a gold. Or a police officer, when a thief or a criminal comes, then he prays the Lord. Then he tries to make him repent. So it's more of like a comedy rather than... But comedy aside, there's one movie in which Mammootty, you all been knowing Mammootty, he looks at Jesus' cross and says, he has a very abusive marriage relationship. His wife always says something against him and a nagging type of girl, lady. So he looks at Jesus says, and God, you took cross for few hours. I am taking this cross for so many years. So he was telling with the grief. So these are the things, you know, people say Jesus died. That does not mean we don't have a problem. So these are the regular things. And one movie specifically I want to say is Innocent movie. There's an actor and he tells to his son that God has given me, God gives us what all we don't desire. Suppose we don't desire a big thing and all, but God will give us. But at an unexpected time, he takes it back. So he becomes also a drunkard. Then a few days he goes to this prayer meeting and all. The last stage of his life, then he says, I can't sit and pray like this. He goes back, enjoys the rest of his days, and he dies. Then same way as a comedian says, God, you brought biryani to the lips and took it away. So that is a thing I'll tell later. So I had commented one in Andhra channel. So one girl, Christian girl, had asked me, what does that mean? Biryani you brought to the lips and took it away. So that God brings certain things to you, and when by the time you take it, he takes it and you start crying. So I'll explain it in the later series. So that is how the movies and all put this Christianity and jokes and serious issues together in such a way.
So Dr. Anish, you said something about Kerala comedian actor called Innocent. So is it the same person who was the MP also?
Yes, yes. That's a very, separately I want to take this Innocent. He's from my place only, he's a comedian. A Catholic, and he has entertained a lot of people. See, as I was telling, this dance, acting, film is also a part of life, you know, not only studies. You know, people concentrate on, he got gold medal. We have famous actors from Christian community. So this Innocent is a very lovable person. So once what happened, he had a cancer. See, I just want to say, many of my friends, personally I know many people have a cancer. They go for treatment, they don't go for this prayer meeting. So Innocent had a suddenly diagnosed with a cancer, and people came running, you know, different people, politicians, fame, everyone was contacting him. So later he wrote a book, Laughing Off with Cancer. He was telling it as a joke. So that book is available in Amazon also. Those who are having cancer can read it. So it has become a joke thing. So in his book he has written, or he has said in TV, that one day evening when preacher and his wife came and he was in the house. So they said that I came because yesterday Jesus came to my house and told me to come and speak to you. And the Innocent said, what time? No, 7:30. Then he said, how can he come at 7:30? Jesus was sitting here at that time, from 7 onwards he was here only. So that preacher ran off. Then a few days back, he had taken the number. A few days later, he called that preacher and said, are you free? You please come down. Jesus has again come to my house. So they kept the phone. And at last he says, cancer is not a big problem. People like this, it's a big problem, more than a cancer. So it is not the problem of that preacher. It is that mental illness. You know, suppose these people always, Christians look for diseases, vulnerability, sickness, poverty around. You know, they think that if somebody has a disease or a financial, this you cannot come up. You are a helpless person. You are gone. Now nobody can help you. Only Jesus can help you. It's their mentality. Later, if you see this innocent, he contested election. He started a foundation for cancer people, help people. He's helping people those who are having cancer. He became a Lok Sabha MP for 5 years. He acted in movies. He acted in TV shows and made money. He came up. So now again he's having cancer. He's doing the treatment. Imagine if he had become Christian. They would have all mind controlled him. He would have been in prayer, don't know what to do, waiting for God to do next. So same way it is our mentality. See Amitabh Bachchan also, if you see, that ABCL was down. So that time we never thought he would come up so much. Now I personally, my two relatives, if you see, they got divorced after having a kid. No, I thought one of the ladies had an abusive husband, daily hitting her and all, grown up children. But down the line, I don't know, I was thinking how she is going to come out. So if I was a Christian, I would have thought the only way is Jesus. But later, getting abused by husband, she used to go to a doctor. And then she ended up, that doctor was a divorcee. Then later I found that she is with the doctor now, with one elder child. Another son is with the old husband. And she is doing a business and all. Her husband is a dentist. So people have come up in the life. It is we who Christians, suppose I became a Christian, I think now gone case, you cannot come up. Many people, you give them a chance to come up and you take them to the church every day and tell, I had lost everything and Jesus saved me and I am trying to come up in this life. You, every Sunday you are there crying the same thing, that Jesus help me, I want to come up and all. You practically do the things. And it's not that where they are going also, I just want to elaborate that they don't see the timing also. See, sir, that what happened, I saw a recent video during the flood time. Flood time, 2-3 boys came with a pamphlet. It's there in the YouTube, it was there, to convert this Catholic. Then he's telling, my house is full of water. You please go now. Even if Jesus comes, I will send him now. I want to go to bathroom. If I read Bible, can I go to bathroom? I am totally running around here and there, cleaning water from my house, and you have come with Bible. You see, please, you do one thing. You go and help the people there. There are a lot of people are stuck there. You don't teach Bible now. You first help them. Then let me also do my work. Okay, you go. So these are the things that actually happened. But when you hear all these things, people, one of my patients, I remember, very young girl. She had a cancer and just because a few days before her marriage, the marriage was called off. Then she did a treatment, blood cancer. She recovered and one of the her senior married her. Now their two kids are having, they are having two kids. They are happily settled and her father-in-law is having cancer now. So all these are Christians' families, you know. So. You cannot think that this is the only way people do. Suppose if you become Christian, then you don't know, then you have to convert others, you have to tell others. So many conditions are there. So people don't go. I have seen people doing suicide from Christian community. They are dying in accident, everything like other community people. So they don't go into this.
So basically, at least in the issue of conversions, Kerala is setting a trend. So I expect that whole of India should follow Kerala as far as religious conversions is concerned. So you can conclude, Dr. Anish.
I'll tell with an example. You know, usually you don't hear of much conversion, but recently I had another actress who is a Hindu. Her mother-in-law had a cancer and went to this prayer meeting and got healed. And it seems that her husband also got converted. So when Christians are not converting, you see these Hindus converting. So you see people in the north and all, no? They say that Christians are indigent because they believe in Jesus. But if you see Kerala, Hindus are converting, but Christians are not converting. So does that mean that Hindus are not intelligent? So what happened to this Hindu actress family later? Are they intelligent or stupid? Or the Christians who are having cancer did not convert? Are they intelligent or stupid? I'll give it as a suspense for the next episode.
Thank you.